What up, beauty gang? Today I'm bringing you guys this super bomb dope hair tutorial using Lavvy Hair Lace Front Wig in their Body Wave texture, giving you all type of SZA, Teyana Taylor, and Rihanna vibes mixed into one. As you can see, I'm feeling myself just a little bit, but if you're interested on seeing how I achieved this color and a little bit of detail on the hair, stay tuned. So first things first, I just wanted to show you guys what the hair initially looked like when I first received it. Very beautiful, thick, dense texture. It is 300% density, by the way, so it better be. Then this is how the lace front wig looked prior to me plucking it. It already comes pre-plucked. However, the knots on the lace frontal was not bleached, so I went ahead and made sure I had that taken care of by flipping the wig inside out, coming up with a thick concoction of bleach powder mixed with some 40 developer, and I just applied that all along the lace and then let that sit for a good 30 to 45 minutes. And after that, I went in with my neutralizing shampoo and purple shimmer light shampoo to wash off the bleach from the lace. And then I went ahead and detangled the hair with a small tooth comb while wet. It glided through the hair very nicely, which I was happy to see. And this is all the shedding that I got from that detangling portion. Now I'm gonna go ahead and split the hair into the sections that I want to dye, because I didn't want to dye the whole lace front wig. I just wanted the front and a little bit of the back, as you saw in the beginning clip of this video. So yeah, after I have taken out the sections that I want to dye, I clip away the section that I don't, and then I go in with the 40 volume developer and that powder bleach again. I did use BW2 powder bleach, just in case you were wondering. And as you can see, I'm avoiding going to the root with this bleach because I did want to keep dark roots for this look. I just think it looks a lot better based off my milk chocolate skin tone. So yeah, I avoided the roots and I kind of like feathered it out at the top to give this look a little bit of dimension, but for the most part, all around it is dark roots, which is what I wanted. So now I'm just adding the finishing touches with a small tooth comb to make sure I got every single piece of hair possible. Now this is what the hair looks like after letting the bleach sit on the hair for about 2 hours, then rinsing it out with conditioner and letting it air dry overnight. It came out to a decently light brown color, not as blonde as I would have liked, but light brown, it'll do. And then here I'm just showing you guys the strand test that I did with the color that I used for this hair. I wanted to make sure that the color came up well based off it being a light brown instead of a blonde color, which worked. So this is actually where I make my mistake, okay? I'm showing you guys the ingredients that I used prior. So I used the Adora Cajun Spice, 2 bottles of it. So I poured both bottles into this container, right? Then I decided to do 2.5 pumps of this Ozzy Moist Conditioner. That was where I went wrong. On that test strand that I showed you guys just a couple seconds ago, I only used the Cajun Spice color. No conditioner added, right? In this point in time, I don't know why. I do know why. I watched a lot of videos and a lot of people were saying if you add conditioner to the color, it'll basically make the hair more vibrant and a little bit brighter, which I thought I wanted, but I really didn't need it. Anywho, learned my lesson. I noticed that the more I applied my mixture of the conditioner and color into the hair, it turned into a burgundy-ish weird color. Like, I was really scared this was gonna come out like another cherry cola. Like, man, I spent all that money. So anyway, this is how the hair came out. Not as horribly bad as I thought. It's still a little bit of copper in it, but it's not as copper as I wanted. You can kind of see it's kind of hints of burgundy-ish. I feel like burgundy is more dominant there, so I couldn't go. The next day, went to the store, bought 2 more bottles of Cajun Spice, and this time I decided not to mix it with any conditioner. I just used the dye itself, reapplied it on top of the hair, and that's how I ended up with my ideal color. So if you guys are trying to achieve this color, make sure that you do not add any conditioner in it, or even if you still want to take that risk, do not use Ozzy Moist. I don't know what it is with Ozzy Moist, but it did not go well with the Cajun Spice. So don't be me, save your money and follow your first instinct. All right, you guys, so I just want to share a couple of quick specs and deets on this hair. This is Lavvy Hair 1B, well, it was 1B. 1B lace front wig, 300% density in their body wave texture. I am gonna give you guys a breakdown of like pricing and shedding and tangles and whatnot, but I do want to say, based off what I've observed with having the hair thus far, I do think that definitely dyeing this hair changed the pattern in the front, because I noticed that the pattern in the back is definitely still like wavy, body wave-ish, whereas the front, it kind of got a little bit of flattened and stretched out. I
think from the bleaching process, obviously. So I just wanted to add that in there. I mean, obviously it's not that noticeable, and if you rock some like wand curls with it or like flat iron it straight, like it'll look good. I mean, I still think it looks decent, but just wanted to mention that. Now, as for pricing, it varies depending on what length of the wig you get. So this is a 24 inch lace front wig, which is the highest length that they offer in this hair texture, and the lowest length that they offer is 12 inches. So the price range between 12 inches and 24 inches, which is what I have, is $158 to $292. And then obviously different lengths and stuff fall in between those two numbers. In terms of shedding, I'll definitely say it's about a 5. Every time I brush it, comb it, run my fingers through it, hairs do come out. In terms of the wig's density, it's definitely an 8 out of 10. I love how full this hair is, and I will say, although I did kind of pluck and alter the front part of the wig a little bit, it did come pre-plucked. If you're kind of like a lazy wig maker, I think that this wig would be a decent choice for you. In terms of the hair's length, I definitely gave it a 10 out of 10. This hair is definitely long, and I'm pretty positive it is the whole 24 inches. It reaches, to my booty, the nape of my booty. Yeah, this is a really long wig. So like I said, the 24 inch is $292, but if you go any lower than that in lengths, then it's gonna get cheaper for you. So if you're not like the booty length type, which I'm really not, I don't even know how this happened, but if you're not that type, then you will be saving money. In terms of coloring and bleaching, I gave it a 7 out of 10 because I honestly wish the hair color would have lifted a little bit brighter than that light brown color it gave me, but it is what it is. It was fine. The color still came out pretty bombs. In terms of tangling, I will give it about a 6. It definitely tangles throughout the day. Not in a horrible way where your hair will necessarily look ratchet, but you will know that it's tangled. Now, I don't know about you guys, but that gets very frustrating for me when like I try to run my fingers through and it's like that. Granted, I just brushed it before I got on the screen, but I will say it's not hard to brush out at all, so that is a perk. For their service, I definitely gave them a 10 out of 10. This is not my first time working with Lavvy Hair. I've always had awesome customer service from them, and they're very much so on the ball when it comes to responding to their customers if there's an issue and whatnot, which is why I try to advertise brands that I personally like to you guys that I received good vibes from, because I'm not going to send you guys nowhere this heck. Bad vibes, rude customer service, people who just don't give a F, you know, so definitely always love and appreciate Lavvy Hair's customer service. In terms of the nape area of the hair, I gave that a 5 out of 10 because it does tangle just like the rest of the hair. For the shipping, I gave a 10 out of 10. They get the hair to you relatively quickly. You order it on Monday, you will get it about by the end of the week at the latest, but at some point in the middle of the week you should receive your hair. And yeah, overall I do like the hair. I definitely am a fan of Lavvy Hair in general as a hair company. I actually do plan on possibly cutting this wig into like a bobbish type thing. I don't know, I'm nervous, but I wanted to get this video out first just in case I mess up the hair, because that would be a little ratchet to get on here and have them jacked up a wig review. But yeah, overall I do like the hair. So if you guys have any other questions, please don't hesitate to leave them in the comment section below. I will have the hair details, direct links and whatnot for the hair in the description box below. And even if this 300% lace front body wave texture isn't necessarily your thing, they do have tons of other different patterns, textures, bundles, lace fronts, whole wigs. Like, go check out their website for sure. But yeah, that's all I want to share with you guys. Really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hope you thought my color is bomb after everything I went through to get it. Don't be me. And yeah, until next time guys, bye.